Okay, we should start now. Very good afternoon. This is Abhay from Manupatra Information Solutions. Thank you for joining me for this orientation session for Manupatra subscribers. So I hope you are well at home at this difficult time for all of us. Let's make the most of it by just brushing up on our legal research skill. Let me begin with a quick introduction to my company. Manupatra Information Solutions started a journey in the year 2000 as the pioneers of the online legal search in India. Since then, we have grown into the largest content aggregator for Indian and international database, covering both primary and secondary data. What has helped us stay relevant for 20 years in the industry is, apart from our loyal clientele, our continuous focus towards innovation and technology. So we think of ourselves as a technology company in a publishing industry. So there are a lot of simple, easy-to-use features that are available, but at the back end, there are a lot of technology that goes into it, like artificial intelligence, natural language processing, visualization tools. We have a gamut of visualization tools, editorial inputs at right places. So a lot of thought goes in Manupatra on how to make our user reach the best document in the least possible time. Okay, so with that, let's come with that to this session. So this session is targeted for Manupatra subscribers. So this will be for 3 days, beginner level, intermediate level, and advanced level. So I'll encourage you guys to take all the three sessions because this will comprehensively cover everything that we have in the website. We'll cover each at different levels. Okay, the idea is just at the end of it, you will also be given a open book test. So, you will be given a username and a password from which you will be able to sign in into the portal. We'll also share a questionnaire, so that link will also be active. So you can just do that questionnaire after you have completed this session. The idea being that you learn much more through deliberate practice than I just showing my demo to you. Okay, so let's start. So I'll start everything, I'll explain everything as a beginner. We'll assume that you have some legal knowledge, no information about Manupatra, never used it. So I'll be teaching everything from the scratch. Okay, so just type manupatra.com here on the. So either it will load to Manupatra or manupatrapass.com. Both are the same things. This is the same website. From here, you will be able to the sign in and password. So this will be given to you, the username and password. So you can access with that. Again, if your college has an IP subscription or your law firm has an IP subscription, there will be an option available here. IP access users, click here. So whenever you are connected to your college Wi-Fi, that option appears. And from your college Wi-Fi, you will be able to access from this button. Okay. Let's get into the system. So this will be my home screen. Okay, so this is how Manupatra looks from the inside. On the left-hand side, we have different table of contents. This is everything that we are covering in the website. Okay, now on the right-hand side, there are different searches. Manu search is there. So, first time you look at a search engine, you start looking for the search bar. So this is our search bar, Manu search. So this is available right here. Another one is legal search. So different searches are there for specific purposes. Citation search similarly is there. Okay. Similarly, this is new that we have introduced, assisted search. So we'll come to each one of them in 5-10 minutes. So let's start with the table of contents. So table of contents in Manupatra has two major purposes. One is it will show you the depth of coverage in Manupatra. The second one that it can also be as a filter. So when you are making your search, you can always start, you are looking for a Supreme Court judgment. So you can just click on the Supreme Court button from here. And now when you go to Manu search or legal search, it will only search in the Supreme Court judgments. So before even making your search, you can, if you are very specific that this is a Delhi High Court judgment that I'm looking for, you can just select Delhi High Court from the High Courts. Okay. let's show you the coverage. So for Supreme Court judgments, we cover from 1950 since inception till today. All the judgments that have been passed from Supreme Courts are available here. Similarly, for Supreme Court orders from 1980 till today, all the Supreme Court orders are also available. For the high courts, so all the 24 high courts, comprehensive coverage is there. Say I'll show you for one, Calcutta High Court, the oldest court in India. Say from 1860 till today, all the Calcutta High Court judgments are available from here. Okay. Similarly, other courts also we cover. In other courts, what we mean by other courts is the Privy Councils, the Federal Courts. So these are basically the 1950, before 1950 courts. So all the judgments from dating back from 1850 onwards are there. So sometimes we still get calls from clients that this is a Privy Council judgment that is required. So all these are available here. Very comprehensive coverage for high courts. Coming on to the next one, this is the tribunals and commissions. So all the major tribunals and commissions are also covered by Manupatra. All the 40, we cover 40 tribunals. So DRT, NCLT, ITAT, NCDRC, all these are available. So NCLT is specifically these days very popular among advocates. So all the benches you can see from here. So all the benches, say you want just the New Delhi bench judgment, select and make your search from Manu. So it will only search in the New Delhi bench judgment from NCLT. Okay, so this is about it in terms of table of contents. There is a lot to unpack here. So there are many features that I am not covering today since it's a beginner course. It's a refresher course for you. So tomorrow I'll be going in depth with this table of content. Let's come to the search part. So there are different searches, Manu search. So some of the old clients might be there. So this is the heart of Manupatra. This is most of our users are heavily dependent on Manu search. So this is basically a text based search. So in this you will be able to see like you just have to enter your text, just like Google. You put your text and you will get results. Say I'll put for one, say appointment. This is my query, appointment of arbitrator. So within half a second, it has fetched me 19,000 some judgments on appointment of arbitrator. So from here, you will be able to see that automatically it has taken appointment of arbitrator as a phrase. So it uses natural language processing also. So where you don't have to, you know, think much about writing your query here. So this was for Manu search. We'll come back to Manu search in a while. Let's go to legal search first. So legal search is when you have a particular act in mind. So, you know, you are starting your search with a particular section in mind. So you can put your section here if you have an appellant respondent in your mind, that can be done from here. Okay, so this is there. We have also planned some polls for you. So I'll just conduct one. So this is a Privy Council judgment covers. This poll will start just to make it more interactive. So the question is, Privy Council judgment covers judgments before. Okay, so from here, the correct answer is fastest finger first, that is 1950. Okay, so 1950, pre-1950 judgments are the Privy Council judgments. So we'll keep doing such exercises, you know, just to make it more interactive. Okay, so let's come to the search. So this is appellant respondent search. So once you have a party name in mind, you can use this. This is a very common search. You know, people just have sometimes the party name and they're looking for that judgment. So I've prepared one for you. So this is party name. So this is the Sabriwala case. Sabriwala case is how it's popularly known. There's a different party name to this case. Let's go and type Sabriwala in appellant respondent. What do we find? Okay, so since it's a popular judgment, we have also from Sabriwala case also you'll be able to find. So like some popular judgments are there. So for that you will be able to find that from legal search also, appellant respondent. This is a very common thing. This is the first thing that people search. Therefore, we are showing you this one first. Now, how do we do this search when we have a party name in mind? Okay, so when you have a party name in mind, you can just these are all the this is the party name. So you don't have to write the this entire thing in the appellant respondent. Okay, can just write one party or two parties. Okay, so whichever party, no need to write versus or anything. Just put in the appellant name. So I'm just taking the appellant name. Okay, this is Kantaru, and I'm making a search. Okay, so whichever judgments, Kantaru, Rijaru, Rijavarus, I'm sorry. So all these judgments where this Kantaru, Rijavaru was a party. So these are all four judgments that you can see. So what happens when you search from legal search appellant respondent, this only searches in the title of the judgment. So it's not searching the entire body. Sometimes people go and search in Manu search with the party name. That time, sometimes what happens is, you know, it has been quoted in some other judgment, which is a landmark judgment. So that name comes up. So always use legal search appellant respondent for that. Okay. So this was our case 2019. It has been cited once. If you want to see the case note, that you can see from Act and prior history from here. Okay. So once you get your case, another mistake that people tend to do is they just click on this one. So this is not a mistake. They have found that their case. This is the full text judgment of the Abdiwala case. Okay. So now when I have to go back, this normally this doesn't work. So there are three different options that we are giving you to back go back to your results page. Okay. The number one is just click on this one. Open last search. So this will be available in the top. Okay. Now if you want to go, this again is available here from back to the results page. Now you are scrolling down the judgment. This particular option is also available. So there are three ways to go back. If you have opened this judgment in the same window, you can use this, any one of these to go back to your main search. So this is my main search. Now a smart way to do this is open any new judgment in a new window. Okay, so that way you are able to see multiple judgments. You will be able to see many judgments from the same Manupatra. Okay, so this is for that button. This is there, this mobile button to open document in a new window. Okay, so now let me show you a template of a judgment, how a judgment looks in Manupatra. So this is the Manu citation. These are all the acts. These are some of the icons that I'll come to. Honorable judges. So everything is hyperlinked. So you will see this small feature. This is judge analytics. This will cover an expert, but very, very useful feature. Very much appreciated by law firms. Subject is also there. So every judgment that comes to Manupatra is given a certain subject. So that is done by a editorial team. All the acts that were used in this judgment, similarly mentioned in where this judgment was mentioned in the future judgments. From here, you will be able to see that these are all the acts that were used in this particular judgment. But relevant sections were just three, Article 25, Article 26 and Article 14. So we have segregated these for you. So this is again done by our legal team. So there's a separate search. So if you're looking for just judgments on Article 14, so you can make a separate search for that. This is referred. So everything that is in Manupatra is cross-referenced, comprehensively cross-referenced. So any Supreme Court judgment, High Court judgment, notification, any act, anything is hyperlinked. So you can easily jump from one judgment to another. So, you know, this is a very small common feature, but it's not available with many players. So this is, everything is hyperlinked. So let me click on say one judgment. Okay, let me click on this one. Okay. So this is a UA judgment. From here, you will be able to see that Manupatra provides both the national as well as international judgment. So you will be able to see, you know, you will be able to jump from one judgment to another. If you're looking for a, you know, Supreme Court judgment from US, that also you will be able to do. So this will be the prior history. So which was the early disposition is there. Authored. So if you want to read Gogoi search first or Nariman search first, that also you can just click here and you will be able to see the Nariman search part, which is authored. Similarly, rules are also hyperlinked. So this is Supreme Court 2013 rules. So this is the benefit of Manupatra. So just click on to that one and it will take you to the rules. Now I can read, say, part 4. I can read this one. So 18, I guess. So this is there. Copy paste is very simple. So many software does not allow you to, you know, copy more than one. Everything from here, you can just open Notepad. So you can just copy paste anything and the name of the party will automatically come down. So very easy for drafting. Another thing that you know, especially for students, that's very helpful is double click on any word and there will be a no more option. So this is the dictionary function. So the legal dictionary can be seen from here. So similarly, this is for any maxim you come across, you can select that phrase. So this no more option is very, very useful. Just double click on any word that you know you want to find the meaning. Just double click on that one. And from there, you will be able to see the dictionary meaning of that word. It's very easy to, you know, find out words that you don't know the meaning of. Similarly, hyperlinking is there. It's from here. See that this again you can use if you want to go up, down the judgment. So for the navigation, this is very helpful. Let's go up. So this is the Manu citation. So we cover more than 330 citations. So equivalent citation, if you want to look for any other journal's citation, you have a book of a particular journal. So that way also you can always come here and select this one and you will get the equivalent citations for that case. Okay. So these are different features. So the top list I am not touching today. We will be covering that in tomorrow. So after the session, you will be given a username password. Open any landmark judgment and go through these, you know. So tomorrow you will be more prepared for questions or doubts on this one. Okay. So let's come to the bottom line. So this is just how to take a PDF printout for any judgment. So if you want with case note, without case note, both are possible. So just click onto this button. This is readily available for you. Okay. Now this will be there. The equivalent citations will be on the top. Your name will be here. Manu Patra, very authoritative, 20 years. So that also helps. This is email. So if you want to send an email to a friend, to a colleague from here, that you will be able to do. So no need to, you know, download the judgment, put it in email ID, then send it. Just put in the email ID, any friend you can put in the email ID of, and just send from here and it will go directly from here. Similarly, word format. So, you know, for drafting, it's very much appreciated, this feature. So we get calls for this one often. So this is word format. So this is also available. This is enable sticky note. So you can always highlight some, you know, you found some paragraph which is important. You can also leave a trail. So this is a very advanced feature. So we'll be covering this one tomorrow. Google Drive. So if you want to save this particular judgment in your Dropbox or on your Google Drive, that you can do. Just set up your account here. It will easily go to your cloud. Now, if you want to save it in our cloud, you're always welcome. You can save this document in any folder. Say, created Sabriwala here. I can save it. So whenever you save this judgment, then you can go back. My saved documents will be there. So suppose you're working on your office laptop or office computer, you save this judgment in this folder. Now you can access it from here. So, you know, you're working on a particular case, you found these like 10, 12 judgments that are relevant. You can just create that folder and you can index basically. So indexing is possible very easily. No need to, you know, we are living in that age. So physical is difficult for some time. So everything is saved in cloud. Okay. This one is also there, order timeline. So this basically gives you the timeline for all the judgments. This particular judgment, before this, many orders might have come. So that timeline that you can access from here. Okay, let's come to the next one. This is the print replica. Okay, so print replica is the source of this document. So this is basically the code copy for this judgment. I think my internet It's not helping me. Okay. Click on Judas. Okay. Till the time this one loads, we can take some questions. Okay. Go back. Question answers. Okay. We will provide you the login ID password after the session. So no worries, sir. Okay. So sometimes the internet comes, like we are making sure that we are using good bandwidth system here, but sometimes there will be problems. Come back to this and open Judas again. And okay. Any more questions? If you have, I can take them. I've joined late. Can I, so this will be uploaded in our YouTube channel. So I'll just show you where you can find this. So once the login details sir would be provided after the judgment. Boolean search, sir, I am going to cover Karthik, sir. The Boolean search will be there. High court rules are not provided, the judgments are provided. Okay, let's get back to, let's see if the internet gods are, okay, now this is working. Okay, so this is print replica function, this one. From here you will be just come to this. So this is, from here you will be able to get to the source document. So this is the, as it is, this is the court copy basically of this judgment. So in every judgment from Supreme Court or from High Courts, you will be able to find these. Okay, so what many publishers are doing these days, that they are changing the paragraphs of the judgment, and sometimes we get the complaint that there are some spelling mistakes also. So sometimes the spelling mistake is also in the source, so we can't do anything about that. So we have provided you the court copy from the site itself in the judgment. So this many journals also we cover. So this print replica same will be available there. So this will be available in all the judgments from here. So print, just click on print replica Judas, and you will be able to access the court copy for any judgment. Okay. So this is here. Okay, this was for the judgment. Now time for another poll. Okay. So we were at legal search. Now let me just go back. We had covered this one. Citation we had covered. Okay. So we were at legal search. We had browsed one judgment from that, you know, from the case name. So that we had covered. Now let's come to legal search. Sometimes the question comes, you know, you have a particular section in hand and you want to make your search on that particular section. So just, you can always write Indian Contract Act. Select 1871, Indian Contract Act 1871, 1872. Okay, and search on section 9. Okay, so just select the act and write section. So sometimes people just write section here also. So there's a separate filter that is given from here, section 9. Okay, and you will be able to make that search. Once you have filled that form, you can just search from here. सर्च. Let's come back to legal. Okay, and start from here. Say I want to change this IPC 300 to. Click 302 and make your search. So all the judgments from here on this section IPC 302 you will be able to see. Now again, sorting can be done in terms of relevance, decision date. So if you want to see the most recent decision on this case, that you can do from here. So newest one. If you wanted to see the most cited decision on 302, that also is possible. So sometimes you just begin your search with a particular section in mind, that you can do from here. Always you can search in results. So if you have a particular query also in your mind, so you can a text query, so you can always refine your search from here. Okay, coming to the left hand side, this is the filters. So filters are basically designed to, you know, enhance your search. So if you are just looking for a Supreme Court judgment, you need not select it from here. You can just select, these are 5000 sub judgments on IPC 302 on Supreme Court. Now again, keywords are there. So keywords basically prompt us to, you know, which are the common words that are occurring in each judgment. So common intention 6000 sub judgments is there, confession 8000 sub judgments are there. So this is also that you can use to refine your search. So sometimes you are, you know, you are blank, so you can just go here and look for suggestions from here. Similarly, judge wise, so if you have a particular judge in mind, so you can always select this, you know, from there. This is period wise. So if you're looking for 2010 and above, 2010 judgments, 2020, so 872 judgments, 852 judgments have already come on this topic of IPC 302. So this is again for filtration, this is available. Document type, if you want to read case laws on this, business policy, industry. So we also segregate judgments based on the industry. So education industry, oil and gas. So we have partners who are working, or clients who are working in, you know, intelligence agencies. So specific, if you're looking for bank cases only, so 9 bank cases are also there. Okay, let's come to the judgment wise. 5 or more judges were there. You want to read that judgment first. So there's 79 plus judgments. So this is filtration and this is for cited. So if you want to cite, sort your judgment based on relevance. Relevance is, ideally you should always put it in relevance, because this is based on our algorithm, you know. So this is like, you don't have to go to the page number 2. All the top 10 results will give you the most relevant judgments that are being quoted recently on the topic. So this is how do you make your search on a particular section. Now coming to the judge bench, so if you have a particular judge sub in mind, say I am seeking or looking for Bobde sir's decision, so just write Bobde sir. So now you can make your search. So these are like 1017 results you have found, and you want to see, you know, you read on in paper something, so you can always see the newest one. So this is the newest decision that is recently authored. So this is judges wise. Similarly, case note, if you just want to make your search in the particular case note. So sometimes gender justice might not be in the judgment, but our editorial team might have put in that. So this is also very helpful, case note search. Subject wise, so any judgment that comes in Manupatra is given different subjects. So contract is one, criminal is one, constitution, company is one. So if you're an NCLT lawyer, you can just select company subject and make your search. From there you will be able to find new cases of, so that is possible from here. Subject, date. Now this is also very commonly, you know, we get calls for this. So sometimes people, what they do is they find a old newspaper article on a particular subject, because everything is available on net. So on 20th, Delhi High Court say this delivered some judgment, so you can just select that particular date, select date, go to Delhi and make your search. Similarly, you can do it for any other code. Okay, so on 20th August 9, 2019, 29 judgments came from Delhi High Court. So here, from here, you can always search in result and you will be able to get to that judgment. Also, you can just go to the third page. So that way, if you just have a party name in mind, that way also you can get there. So this is from legal search. So the difference between Manu search is basically a text-based search. Legal search is more in terms of, if you have a particular section in mind, if you have a particular appellant respondent in mind, so this is there. Let's come to the next one. This is a citation search on Manupatra. So this is Indian citation. So we have multiple citations, more than 320 citations we cover in Manupatra. So from volume 1 till volume today, so all these judgments are available from different volumes. I'll just quote you once, AIR. And let's go for Supreme Court. So AIR Supreme Court. Year number you can put 1973. And since it doesn't have a volume, you can put page number 61. So this is, just fill this form. If you have any citation, say Manu citation is there, you can put the Manu citation there. You can put the year and volume number. Very easy. You know, some softwares need that special format you need to remember, nothing like that. Just make your search. Partially also you'll be able to make this search. So just click on to this icon. From here you will be able to get to that case easily. So this is the landmark Keshav Nanda case from legal search, from the citation. So only the citation you have, if you have, you will also be able to make your search. Okay. Now, before the interruption happened, we had this query, how to use Boolean search in Manupatra. So there is a way to use that in Manu search, but this is, we have introduced recently assisted search. So this is getting a very good reputation. So this is basically just everything is explained here. I'll just pick some keywords and make my query, say child custody visiting rights. Okay, so now here it says all these words. So these are the four words that I want in my judgment. All these four words should be there in the judgment, you know, very self-explanatory. Just select. Okay, might have made a spelling mistake somewhere. You have to be careful here. Rights and make your search. Okay, so now you see that there are 3000 some judgments categorized relevance where all these four words are coming: child custody visiting rights. So you know, visiting rights might be somewhere, child custody of the minor child might be somewhere. So now what if you want that this particular, these four words should be in a range, you know, this might be anywhere in the judgment. Child custody might be in the first paragraph, visiting rights can be in the last paragraph. So to counter that, there is this, these words in a proximity within. So just write child custody visiting rights, and now I can give a range. You know, I don't want the entire judgment, I want like say 20 words. So in whichever judgment these two are coming in a range of 20 words, I want only those judgments. Go back to assisted search. We have done till now at least 12-15 demos, this webinars. This is the first time that we are facing difficulties. Let's do this again. Okay, so here I'll just put all my four keywords here, and this is proximity within 40-20 words. So all these judgments with my keywords are coming in a range of 20 words. Okay, so sometimes this is like what most people, like new users, do, that they write entire like 2-3 sentences in Manu search or in Boolean search. To negate that, just find whatever is your keyword. You know, you have to know what is exactly that you're looking for. That way your easier is much more simpler. Otherwise also you'll be able to find judgments, no problem. But if you want to do it efficiently, just remember which keywords you want, and if those keywords are not fetching you judgments, it's probably a good idea to change that particular keyword, you know, some other word that might be used in that. So this is one. Another one can be, say, I can put a particular phrase, you know, inverted commas. So you just put dowry death here. So in whichever judgment, okay, I don't want to select proximity. So in whichever judgments, dowry death is coming as a phrase. So we have 4,000 some judgments where dowry death is coming in phrase. Now I can always, you know, look more into the, like 4,000 results. I can refine more in this one. So how do I do that? Dying declaration, and I can give it a proximity. Say I want just 10 words. Within 10 words in whichever judgment, dying declaration is coming and dowry death case is there. Okay, so now you will see that only 822 results are there. So from here you will be able to say none of these words. So say there was no witness. I'm just taking an example. So there was no witness. You don't want judgments where witness is coming. So you can just negate that word. So or particular section is coming, you can also write that here. Now we have just 7 results where dowry death is there, dying declaration is coming in proximity. So this is how do you use assisted search. Okay, we have just prepared another question for you. This is, under what circumstances fail can be given under section 354 of IPC. So I want you to read this again and, you know, think of what are my keywords here, and then I will make a search. Okay, so let's say these are my 4. So I'll come back to my assisted search and write, say, IPC. I guess section was 354 and bail run. And I'll give them a proximity of, say, 20 words. Let's see what happens. Okay, so now I've got 50 results. Okay, so where anticipatory bail was granted, grant for regular bail. So these are very relevant results for me, like 50 top most results on the desired subject. So this is how you know you can use Boolean in this without using any formulas, nothing. Just I have just put in my 3-4 keywords. The idea being that, you know, sometimes people write a lot of keywords. The idea is to use less keywords, you know, and the precise ones. Okay, so this is therefore from assisted search. Now let's go back to the next one. So we had covered legal search, we have covered citation search, we have covered assisted. Let's come to Manu. So Manu search, again, as I was telling you, this is the favorite search of many of our users. So just because it fetches you a result, just if you write, you know, quote unquote complicated query for any search engine, order 7 rule 11a. Okay, so automatically it will fetch you results relevant to order 7 rule 11a. So no software is able to do this. Even if they are able to do this, there will be like very complicated functions. Manu search, what people like to do is they just type their query. So that is what they prefer. They are more ways to use this, so we will discuss that tomorrow or day after tomorrow session, how to use Boolean in Manu search. If you are not comfortable with Boolean in Manu search, you can always go back to assisted search, that we have given the entire format there. Okay, so this is one. Say I'll write something else, guidelines for unorganized labor. Okay, And I'm looking for Supreme Court rulings on this. Okay, so from here, no, just by typing your query, first one is, I think that many, that seven judgments have found. Okay, so these are the guidelines. So guideline directions. So, you know, just in a matter of seconds, the first is the most relevant result for me. I don't even have to go to the second one. So this is the beauty of Manu search. Let's do one more search, then we can go to the Excel probably. Okay, so this is LGBT rights. So there's a landmark case that came last year. Okay, so LGBT rights have also selected Supreme Court. So it's giving me five results. Okay, so these are all these. So this is the landmark judgment 2018 that overruled the previous 2013. Now 2013 is the overruled judgment that we know from media. So how do I know in Manu Patra? Every overruled judgment has this flag, red flag. You know, red flag denotes that there's something wrong with the judgment. So any judgment you find this red flag, you will see that there's a problem. So this is a very common question. How do we find out that a particular judgment is overruled or not? You know, for any overruled judgment, there will be a red flag in that, in front of that. Okay. And once you click onto that red flag, my second question gets answered. Where was it overruled? So this was overruled by Navtej Singh Johar and others versus Union of India. Okay. So you can easily find in Manu Patra where a particular judgment was overruled and if it is overruled or not. There are many, many features, like in citing references, you can see where a case has been cited, where it's been recently cited. So that those features will be coming today. I've taken enough of your time today, so we'll do that tomorrow. Just two things before I let you go. Like, one is how to get to an act through Manu Patra. See, legal search, advanced search is there, citation is there, international. Now there is an option for act search also. Okay, so just click on this one, act search, and from here you will get a window for how to get to your section. So I can write CRPC, right, first three letters. So now it will prompt me which CRPC I want to look into. That is 1973. Here is an option for view the selected act. Okay, so I've just written CRPC and this is my act. Okay, so this is, I can take out a printout of this, I can copy paste this, no problems. If I want a commentary on this, I can read the commentary on this. So that is all available from here. So this is the commentary. So to access commentary on any bare act, so, which we are providing, so just click on the commentary on the left hand side, there will be commentary. So any substitution might have been done on that particular act, so that is also hyperlink. So these are various hyperlinks are available here. Okay, now let's come to the next one. So similarly, you will be able to find all the bare acts from here. So this is act search under legal search. Advanced search is there, citation, act search. Okay, last thing that I'll tell you today, this is for dictionary and maxims. So if you, there is an option for dictionary, if you just want to go find out the meaning for a particular word, the dictionary option is available here. Similarly, if you want to find out the maxims, you know, so maxims are also available. So some Latin maxim is there. So you can just come here and find for yourself. So this is there. What we covered today was how to sign in Manu Patra, how to find the overruled judgments, how to make a party name search, how to search through section, legal dictionary, how to use filters. So this is the basis of the next two sessions that we'll be having. So that in that session we'll be covering a lot more advanced features. You have been very patient with me, so thank you. So this is open book test. Okay, so this username and password you can use. Begin test lawyers 123. Okay, that you can access from here. I'm also sharing with you the link for the judgment and the questionnaire. Okay, So I'll just show you how to do this. You can just go to your browser and click onto that. Simply, I'll just share this first in my tab. Okay, question and answer. Screen is gone. Broadcast message. Okay. Sir, commentaries, current sir, commentaries are available for central acts, selective ones, sir, not complete. We cover 80% deck. The major acts, you will find the commentaries. Overrule judgments, Lakhan sir. Overrule judgments, once you open any, say, open one, on can, yes, and search. There is one with railway and there is one with railways. So sometimes you get confused. So which is the most cited? Okay. So it said this judgment, whichever judgment has this flag in front of that, that judgment is overruled. Okay. So from here you will be able to see the overruled judgments. This judgment do not have a flag. Only the first two judgments have the flag. So these two judgments are overruled. Okay, somebody asked, Neil sir asked for the summary. So summary is provided here, act, case note. So in front of any judgment, you will find this flag. Okay, so this arrow. We cover this in detail tomorrow. So tomorrow you can join us. So I'll show you how to take out a printout of this, how to take out the printout of all the summaries in the first page. Yes, sir, we can jump from one case to another through hyperlinking. Hitanshi ma'am, we'll cover that tomorrow. So let me just, I've taken a lot of your time. I'll just share the link so that you'll be able to do your test. So this will also come your, might be available in your mail. You send it in your mail, just copy this one and paste it here. Okay, so from here you will be able to access the test. Just go to your question answer option and this link will be there. Okay, Sid Akash, just finish the test, we'll make sure that you get your this certificate. Okay, within a day or two you'll get your certificate. So just copy this one into your Chrome option and paste it there. To get into the site, use this password, begin test lawyers life one. From here just go to Manu Patra or Manu Patra fast, use this button, lawyers life begin test, and use password as lawyers life one. Okay, and click sign in and you will be able to log into a reporter. Okay, so I'll just show you again, begin test lawyers life one. The link I have already shared with you from here. Okay, Vijay sir is asking to log in again. Just come back, just go to manupatra.com, username, password, and sign in. Okay, and your username password is begin test lawyers life one. Begin test lawyers life one. This will be active for 1 hour. The test will also be active for 45 minutes. So you can do that. You can also read a judgment that you want to read. So any research that you want to do. Thank you, Vijay sir. Thanks to you. You have been very patient with your time and with us. Okay, so if you have any queries regarding this in accessing, having any issues, you can just write to us at contact@manupatra.com or you can contact me at this number. Hopefully you will join me tomorrow for another session which will be glitchless. Okay, so थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम. आई विल जस्ट शेयर माई नंबर अगेन, एंड दिस इज द कॉन्टैक्ट आई डी दैट यू कैन राइट टू अस इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम लाइक करेंटली एक्सेसिंग द वेबिनार और यू हैव लाइक सर्टिफिकेट इफ यू वॉन्ट समथिंग एनी प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू मनुपात्रा. Just reach out to us at contact@manupatra.com. If you have suggestions also, you can just write to us. Adar sir, very good question. How this descented we'll be covering in tomorrow. So today I just showed you the overruled one. Tomorrow I'll show you how to see where a judgment has been descented or not. Okay. Meghna ma'am, you should be using if it in your laptop. I guess you're using it in your laptop. Just go to manupatra.com from here, and you'll get to this website. Username password is there. Should I share the password again? So this is Begin Test Lawyer's Life 1. Rishabh sir, I'll take the commentary question again tomorrow, and this video will also be uploaded on YouTube. Okay, login credentials again. Begin Test Lawyer's Life 1.